22nd Sunday in ordinary time, year A of the church calendar, being the 30th day of August. Our readings will be coming from Jeremiah chapter 20, verse 7 to 9. Our responsorial psalm will come from Psalm 63, verse 2, A and B. Our second reading will come from Romans chapter 12, verse 1 to 2. Our gospel message will come from Matthew chapter 16, verse 21 to 27. The theme of our message today is doing the will of God. Doing the will of God, not our own will. And that's why today you can see from the gospel message, Jesus began to show his disciples that he's going to Jerusalem and he's going to suffer in the hand of elders and chief priests and the scribes. And they will kill him. But he will rise up on the third day. When he said this, Peter called him and said, "Oh, God forbid. That can be your portion. Let not such happen to you at all." And Jesus looked at Peter. When he had the Christ, the Messiah, the Son of the living God, looked at him and said, "Get behind this Satan. You are on the side of men, not on the side of God. You are hindering me from attending the purpose of which the Father called me." And he made it clear to Peter, he said, "Get behind me." And when he said this, he's on the side of men, not on the side of God. Then he told them, his disciples, "Look, if anyone wants to be mine and be my own follower, you must renounce yourself and follow me. You must deny yourself. Anyone who wants to save this life will lose it. And anyone who loses this life for my sake will keep it. Doing it according to the will of God. Living for God and living for God alone. Proclaiming him and proclaiming nothing else. Not on the side of men. Not on the side of the world. But on the side of the will of God." And he said, "What will it benefit you if you gain the whole world and forfeit your life? And what will you pay as a ransom for your life?" What? So he's making you to know that God is the ultimate. Doing the will of God is the ultimate aim of your being. And the ultimate aim of God who created us. And that's why today, Paul was telling the Romans, say, "Look, I appeal to you, brethren, by the mercy of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God." A living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God. If you don't imitate the world around you, if you imitate the world around you, become a worldly man. And when you're a worldly man, you're doing the will of God. You are doing the will of men and the will of the world. And automatically, you become an enemy of Christ. You see, but when you are in him, you see, what you do is that you go into him who transforms you. God who transforms us. By the renewal of our minds, he transforms you, become a new creation. I see 2 Corinthians 5 says, "What's in Christ, you become a new creation. The old self disappears." When you are him, you are transformed, you are renewed into a new personality. So that you might prove that you are doing the will of God. It is in living for God that you do the will of God. And doing what is good and acceptable and perfect. If you accept the will of God, it becomes, the will of God is perfect, is good, is acceptable. When you conform to the will of God, automatically you are in him. So the only way you can be in God is by doing his will. The only way you can perfect is by doing the will of God. The only way you can do good is by doing the will of God. The only way you can be accepted is to do the will of God. And the other way is for you to know that the will of God It's sometimes not very joyful to many of us, not joyful to the flesh, not joyful to the world. It contradicts the world, it contradicts our flesh. And that's why today Jeremiah was talking about his own experience, about doing the will of God. He said, "Oh Lord, you have deceived me, you have deceived me, I was deceived, because you are stronger than me." You might say, on my own, I wouldn't do it. But because God has deceived me, and I have allowed myself to be deceived, he's stronger than me. He said, "And you have prevailed upon me. I have become a laughing stock, because I am not doing the will of God. I have become a laughing stock. All the days, everyone mocks me, because all the people of the world mocks me. People who are not in God mocks me. Majority mocks me because I'm in God, doing the will of God. But whenever I speak, I cry out. I shout violence and destruction. And now what do you want me to do? For the word of the Lord has become for me a reproach and delusion." Giving the word of God become a reproach for me and a delusion. All the day long. If I say I will not mention him or speak any more about him, his name, there is in my heart as it were a burning fire. In my heart is burns like a burning fire. When I say I will not mention his name again, I will not talk about him anymore, so that I have the peace with the people of the world and have peace with myself and peace with everyone. But when I do that, it will be burning in my heart. Failure to do the will of God will burn your heart. Failure to do your will of God will torture you. It will frustrate you. It will go depressed. And how many of us are suppressed and depressed and are dying? Because you abandoned your peace, your joy, the will of God, and you are doing your own way. You are frustrated. You despair. And now Jeremiah is telling us that even in my bones, he shut up in my bones. I am weary. I'm tired with holding it in. I can't hold it in anymore. I'm tired trying to suppress it, but I couldn't. I cannot. You see, Jeremiah discovered that he cannot afford not to do the will of God. I cannot fail to proclaim what he asked me to proclaim, but it's a reproach to me and the delusion. So you can see the implication of being in God. Doing the will of God is not an easy thing, but you must have discipline yourself and your body and your thought and everything to be able to conform to the will of God. But if you look at the world around you and people around you, you will not succeed doing the will of God. And when you do the will of God, God is in you and you are in God. And that's why the psalmist who understood this so well said, "My soul, for my soul tests, my soul is testing, O Lord. My God, my soul is testing for you, O Lord, my God." You see, we are testing for God. All these things you see happening in our life is that we are testing to do the will of God. And that's why sometimes the demon directs you, that is the word that is the answer you pursue, you will not satisfy. Say his word to pursue with not. As you women, you follow women, you will not be satisfied until you are in God. Our soul is testing for God, nothing else. And when you are in him, you will not be hungry again. When you are in him, you will never thirst again. When you are in him, you are established forever. We ask God to help us to know his will, give us the wisdom to know it, the strength to live in it, and the strength to live it out, without compromising it at any point, so that we can attain the purpose of which God created all of us. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Let the blessings of Almighty God be upon all of us as we celebrate doing the will of God. Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you all.